We're loading up to head to the big house, Crandon Off-Road, our first short course race of the year. As you can see, the trucks are all getting ready. Getting their bodywork on that we're gonna debut here soon, so stay tuned for that. But I'm gonna give you a look through of the hauler actually. A lot of people have questions about the semi, what's inside, and what all spare parts we carry. So we'll give you kind of a walkthrough of what we take to the races and what it takes to get these trucks across the country. So what we got here is a 1999 NASCAR hauler. It's built for the NASCAR trucks. That's why it's got this lump right here. The trucks are just a little bit bigger. It gives us just enough space to, if you can see up there, the trucks barely fit. The Pro 4, we got to put on little tires and wheels just to get it up in there. We haul the Razor and the Pro 4 in this, the Pro 2 in a separate trailer. This holds 100% of our spare parts. So I'll kind of walk you through. We're just in the midst of loading it. So I'll kind of walk you through just a little bit of what we got in here. It's literally everything. Welders. When we're on the road, we have to be able to have anything we need because when we're racing in Wisconsin and stuff like this, it's not like we just head to the local napper or something. So air hoses, everything needs a place because a lot of times when we need parts, we're in a hurry. So, rags. It's a dirty environment out there, boys and girls.
Lots of terry cloths.
Lots of terry cloths. Those things are expensive too. So any terry cloth sponsors, microfibers, whatever you got, we'll take it. Rugged radio cabinet, off the battery, stay on the tender. Charging dock for our impacts and stuff, so it's easy for the guys when they're working on stuff, grab a fresh battery, change them out. All the ruggeds, the transponders are in here charging for the crew guys, hot pit guys. So basically just everything has a place in here. Awning lights, miscellaneous stuff like here, like zip ties. I mean, we got some tons and tons of zip ties, just little things like that. One thing most people think is cool, we have shock parts. We do mostly all of our shock stuff in-house, so everything from shock shafts to valving to obviously some Razor axles or stuff in there, but we do all in-house. Between Nick and Ronnie does a lot too, so we take shocks fully, revalve them based on track conditions or anything like that right here in the semi. That's a big advantage for us. Springs, we got a lot of different stuff in stock, different spring rates, obviously Razor shock, shock parts. Mostly you're not gonna need stuff like that unless you crash, which can happen. We've had our get offs or two. like I said, air filters this time, which is different from us, we're hitting the road for all 8 rounds that we're doing. So we'll go to Crandon, ERX in Minnesota, and then back to Crandon in September, and the semi is never coming back, so. We have to be stocked up to get through 8 rounds of racing, which is, we've never done that before. Normally it's 1, maybe 2, so 3 is stretching it. K&N air filters, just everything. I mean, fab equipment, random tabs, just in case we break something and we need to make a fabricated tab. This is really bad when you get into this drawer. It's not always.
It's like a ball fix.
Converters, sensors, yeah. And what's so, one thing that sucks about having a semi this stacked up is also everyone else comes to our pit when something goes wrong because they know we most likely have it. As you can see here, oh shit tabs. That means oh shit, we messed up. And there's just random stuff in there. So things have hit the fan. Everyone's pissed that drawer's opening up. FK Rodden's. This is a very expensive drawer right here. These things run roughly about $50 a piece. So if you do the math, I don't know, probably $2,000 drawer of just Himes right there. So really appreciate those guys' support. Just stocked of everything basically. DP, oil. We just switched them last year. Super, super pleased with all their stuff. DP lubricants. Another thing people trip out on is our bolt bits. So basically from quarter all the way to half inch, fully stacked in here. So almost any length, nut, washer, whatever you might run into. I mean, there's so much all standard, no metric stuff in here. It's America. So we got most of it all on deck. Sway bar choices for different setups. Yeah, I mean, that's the gist. It's loaded top to bottom. Our max weight we could be going down the road is 80,000 pounds. And this thing weighs like 78,500. So we're right on the cusp of actually even being legal because we have it that packed to the hill. Pro 4 transmission engine. I mean, there's
over $100,000 to drivetrain just right there. I don't really want to add it up. I kind of thought when we were going to do this video, I was maybe going to add up some of the bins, but then I realized I don't want to because it cost me over $100,000 and it's probably worth $30,000. But hey, that's just the way racing goes, right? You do it for the good times, not the dollar bills.
You can kind of peek your camera up there. Not super tall, but all the trucks go up there, all the awning poles go up there, ladders, all the stuff basically that can scratch stuff, trash cans, big awkward objects. We got spare radiators, front bumpers up there. You lose a rear bumper, it's on you. So front bumpers are free, you're allowed to use front bumpers, rear bumpers on you. My dad taught me that a long time ago. Then the lounge, this is kind of during transport, it's one of the safer places, so lots of fragile stuff like trash cans, you know, go up in here.
This might be the cleanest I've ever seen.
Yeah, we keep it pretty clean. The media guys like Paul and Daniel like to come in here and make a mess, but hey, we do our best to keep it clean. We just tidy this whole thing up. So Paul, he's laughing.
I'll do my best out there, dude.
Yeah, I mean, we cook on the road, so all of our cooking supplies kind of end up in here. Team gear will end up thrown in here. Every guy has a locker up top to just throw some spare clothes while they're at the track. So yeah, that's the gist of the semi. Crandon, you can tune in online, Flow Sports. I'll put a link to that in the description. It's $150 a month, but worth it. Some of the best racing you'll see. So excited to get this show on the road in Crandon, and wish us luck.